Welcome back to part 6 of the Middle-earth Shadow of War Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough. We're going to go through the Eltariel questline today, starting with the Three Towers and working our way all the way through as far as we can. I think we can get to the end of the questline, but I can't remember if we had to do some Bruise quests first or not, so we'll find out.
Cover ground more quickly. Once we have retaken these towers, we should find Eltariel. She must know what is happening.
She could be watching us right now.
We need some more grabs.
More.
Idea. For I am chosen. I serve the Witch King, just as you shall.
So I'll probably let my Caragor die here and pull out the Drake since we have it, but we'll see. This guy is vulnerable to stealth and all of that, but it's not worth taking the time at this point because I outlevel him pretty significantly.
Presume to know what is in an elf's mind. Surely this Galadriel would sin the best.
I don't question whether she is the best, only whether she is the first.
Ugal.
Chosen are tenacious indeed. The Nazgul are wise to create such powerful servants.
However powerful the Chosen may be, the ritual to create them is where they will be weakest.
Indeed. When the final tower is ours, we should turn our attention to finding the ritual's location.
So the Drake seems to be working out pretty well for this mission. Glad we grabbed it before doing this one, actually, because it can be a little bit tricky if you're lower level coming through here and doing all these captains, but yeah, this makes it much easier. You can see if you're careful about the angle, you can avoid getting hit by his ranged attack, so your Drake won't die.
These Chosen will stop at nothing to secure the Hydea for their master.
The Witch King cannot be allowed sight over our plans or our forces.
So the Chosen is fairly straightforward. You just have to clear the camp. Before you start the competition, move over to the spot where you'll start the kill competition, with Eltariel, you'll want to make sure you're stocked up on Elf Shot. Other than that, make sure that as soon as the messenger shows up, you'll want to Shadow Strike stun him, and then dominate quickly.
There is another worm we must intercept.
What message does he carry?
Orders for three captains to report to the Chosen Ritual. He'll pass through this camp.
But he's going to find it curiously empty.
Hello.
Since your interrogations, these worms move under guard. I need to high ground to eliminate the escorts.
Not all of them.
We'll see, Ranger.
So yeah, grab the elf shot here, then move into position.
Just seeing them now. This will be easier than I thought. We must learn what he knows.
Are you deciding whom I let live?
Just get the information.
Where are the captains who would become chosen?
They're coming from the fort. They should be here shortly.
Eager to meet us.
Good. Our friendly competition is not over yet.
Yes!
So I'd love to take out that one with stealth, but I don't think I'm going to be able to manage it.
Stand in the way of me becoming chosen? You're gravely mistaken, Gravewalker.
Bulbar.
Start counting.
Enough of you. You are not ruining this for me! I'm gonna be made chosen, even if I have to do it with your blood dripping off my face! You're dead! Bloody ritual!
That's three captains who will not become chosen. But there is no shortage of recruits to take their place.
Any who are selected, we will target. If we cannot yet stop the Nazgul, we will slow them down.
The Witch King secures his citadel with a veil of shadow.
Mm.
So as you can see, the Drake is grayed out. You cannot summon the Drake in Minas Morgul, so I will switch that to the Grog. The Tower of Sorcery is pretty easy up until the very end, and we'll leave that as a bit of a surprise. Hint, you'll just need to follow the prompts for the most part and avoid getting attacked from behind. But when you're running up, you can dominate orcs if you want to. The gem is not really worth it at this point, and the orcs will die towards the end of the quest, so there's no point in really doing it.
Dark magics infest the very bones of this city.
It is no longer Minas Ithil. It is now Minas Morgul.
I tracked the Ringwraith here after we drove him from Shelob's cave.
Came to lick his wounds.
All we did was chase him off. Be on your guard.
Your ability to track the Nazgul. Another gift from Galadriel.
A gift. That is one way to put it.
We are here for the Palantir. That is all that matters.
And we will have to fight our way to it. The city is crawling with orcs.
They need not be obstacles. We can turn them into valuable assets.
Hey, I wanted my elf shed, Eltariel.
I suppose it wasn't the imagination!
Nine will stop at nothing to seize that ring.
This ring is not their prize. It is their destruction.
If you do get a little bit ahead of Eltariel, you can stealth kill, which makes it a little bit faster.
The Ringwraiths cannot be destroyed. They always come back.
But you don't stop fighting.
No. Not ever.
To destroy the Nazgul forever, there must be a way.
If there is, I have not yet found it. Stay by my side, Ranger, and I will show you what a Ringwraith is.
So before you go up the steps here, you'll want to make sure that you're full on elf shot.
We should stick together, Ranger.
Ready to go.
Has taken possession of this city. Now he will take possession of you.
Talion, don't let him catch you outside the light.
I will annihilate.
Dark power is no match for the light of Galadriel.
To my side!
submit to me. You cannot defeat the Nine. You will join them.
Been done to you. Kneel before your king.
Were you granted vision?
Yes.
Then you understand. These were once great men, but they could not resist a ring of power.
Sauron's rings were designed to subjugate their wearers. I realized that too late. But now, I have crafted a ring that is perfect. This one is pure.
Pure what, I wonder?
So, simple quest. Disrupt the ritual, dominate the Chosen, look out for their weaknesses.
That's how the Chosen are created. I thought it'd be more festive.
The Nazgul is entirely focused on the ritual. This is the perfect time to strike.
Archers cover the approach. It would be wise to eliminate them quietly.
If you do dominate the archers, then they come in kind of handy during the fight. It's not mandatory, but they can be helpful.
Skins,
way.
So at this point, it's easier to pull the non-aero immune captains up on top of the tower and summon your captain up there, or pull back a bit away from the Nazgul so the Nazgul won't engage in the fight with you while you're trying to fight the captains. If you try and fight all four at once, it gets really, really hectic. So we will do it the easy way.
Maku. Krosh. Kuga.
So you can see I'm out of elf shot at this point. And despite Eltariel's calls, you can just ignore her. She's not going to bleed to death. I need to recharge my elf shot, so I'm just going to pull up some of the archers up here. Except that they're too weak for me to get too far.
Marco.
Come on, come on. You need help? All right.
To the Witch King, for that is your destiny. You must know this. We will never stop, not with the Chosen, and not with you.
Well fought. But this was not the last ritual, and it will not be the last fight.
With Reversal of Fortune, we're going to want to try and free our captive captains first before we engage the Nazgul and interrupt the ritual. The other thing to keep in mind too is the Nazgul will be joined by some other captains, so we'll want to try and fight someplace that's isolated and that we can separate the captains again like before.
The Nazgul is holding some of your followers.
We must recover them.
Such loyalty to the orcs.
To ritualize me!
So it's easier, I find, if you kind of go this path in kind of counterclockwise around the right to free each of the captive captains.
Your spring, you would come. Now, join your army in service to the Witch King. The Witch King is your true master.
If you do get an Iron Will captain here, then shame him so that he flees the fight. Don't try to fight to the death.
Israel,
betray me, I'll die! I did not like that ritual!
I do my fighting, and I'll fight with you! Nearly sacrificed!
Strong, and we have all but assured the Nazgul cannot track us.
But they are still not defeated. As long as they are out there, we are not safe. You least of all.
Our followers are returned and the Hydea are secure. The Nazgul's power is diminished.
And yet, this sense of dread grows.
Shadow Dominate is a really good ability, and as long as you don't feel like you need to separate the captains, it's worth slotting, definitely, because you can dominate enemies around you without having to go back into skills and swap to something else, or not be able to replenish your elf shot when you're draining enemies. So it's pretty good because it rounds out your skill set. But I still tend to keep Shadow Strike Pulse slotted just because I use it so frequently to make the fights a little bit more strategic. But if you like to really mix it up, then this is a good one to have because you can, you know, go into focus mode, dominate an enemy, and then he's on your side and he'll distract some, and it makes it easier to stay in the thick of things. But it's, you know, it's really up to you. Both are very good skills.
In order to do the next Eltariel quest, the Scourge, we'll need to take the fort for Saragost. And normally what I like to do is send in captains to each of the war chiefs, infiltrate two captains per war chief, and then betray them. But with Shag here, he's got a bodyguard that's hidden that I can't replace, so it's forcing me to do his confrontation mission. So I've tried to deploy new captains as I usually do to replace, but it's not replacing Skak. So I'm going to have to take out Skak and his warchief through the confrontation mission, so we'll start with that.
Grog is drink, medicine, and fuel to the orcs. To us, it is a weapon.
So with the confrontation missions and the keeps, I tend to like to play it a little bit stealthy. So I'll sneak in, find a perch, do whatever the requirement is, and then pull the captain that I'm trying to kill up on top of the perch.
Thank you.
barely feel my fingers.
Note that just because there's an alarm doesn't mean I'm not being stealthy. So we'll keep him around to help with the fight with the Warchief.
I have your back, my lord.
We'll get some elf shot back too. Making sure that I also don't have to worry about any archers attacking us.
Just look at him. Look at him. Look at the anger, the power, the hate.
Shog.
So when they enrage these guys with the two weapons, I tend to back off. Save our captain there. That's unfortunate that he went down.
Mercy! Oh, thank you!
Hodor has one fewer tyrant today.
Does it? Or do the names merely change?
All Alright, since we've gotten rid of that war chief, we'll try and do the infiltration missions from here while we're in the keep. I believe that the pit fight that we need to do is nearby, so we'll just start them from here. Infiltrate six guys in. That'll give us the access to the betrayal missions. Then we'll go off and do each of the betrayal missions one after the other, which will hopefully keep the defenses down.
You want a challenge? Fine.
So if any of our captains die, it's not too big of a deal. We can just send in another, deploy another couple of orcs and then be able to do the next infiltration mission.
Ha! I'm not impressed!
So sweet! So very, very sweet! Very, very sweet, sweet, sweet!
Time for murder!
Gurgle
And you can see this is a good way for your captains to gain levels too.
Azrans.
You need, and then some.
I will pile the corpses high with yours on the bottom.
Enough of you.
will put you in your place.
Another maggot. Perfect.
Caragor! I'll kill you!
So you can see there from the prompt, I now have a betrayal mission, but I'm going to get all of the other betrayal missions lined up so I can fire them off one after the other. Otherwise, you have a higher chance that a new war chief will pop out.
See how well you play dead when you're dead!
You're saving the best for last out there!
Caragor! Hold on to this! Flee from the train of the Mate for the slaughter!
Places, everyone! Too slow!
This is not so good. Oh, the comeback! Yes! Go Rug. So we now have two of the betrayal missions, one more to set up.
You won't be getting past me!
You're gonna fight me or talk me to death?
A Caragor!
I hope you're ready.
Explosion!
Yeah, 11 level gain. That was pretty good. So now we've got all three betrayal missions. We'll just go to this one here because it's closest.
Might as well make him bleed.
So sweet. So, so, so sweet.
This war chief believes he has us where he wants us. Let us show him the error of his ways.
That is not what I was expecting. I thought that would be a betrayal mission.
Fight for Sauron, and I will gladly dedicate your death to him.
So sweet. So very, very sweet. Very, very sweet, sweet, sweet.
Die, trespass!
Thank you.
There we go. Now we have the betrayal available.
Enough human there for us all to torture. Die, boss!
Chosen.
Very well, master.
Sweet.
I see what was happening. So, because I had infiltrated and then I recruited the war chief after I defeated him, or after my captains defeated him, I guess. Because I recruited him, that probably replaced the captain that I had infiltrating the next one. So that's what it looks like happened here. And so I'll need to infiltrate again to get the betrayal mission available again.
Bog.
So, better to just kill the war chiefs, it looks like.
You won't stay alive much longer.
Another victim. Come on.
A Kenegor. Not so fast. Look into my eyes. Yes. Get a lesson in orc supremacy over manswine!
Always hated you!
So this one we could recruit if we wanted to, but he'll replace one of our other captains. Doesn't matter one way or the other, really, because I don't care about any of the captains that I have. So we'll let him die. So Scourge still needs us to get the keep, so that is next. For assaults, generally I like to have mounted archers. The Wargrove. For siege piece, just use whatever ones you want. Defender Host is pretty good because it lets you capture the victory points faster, but Savage Host is also really good. And I tend to use Sappers just so that my force can get through the gates more quickly.
I say we should go in there and teach them some manners!
So it looks like our mount was available for us. Awesome. Yeah. not getting any of the bleeding notifications for me to go rescue them.
Push forward to the square.
Keep going to the training grounds.
Charge!
Go, go, go!
Steady, lad!
Too slow. Sorry, Rook. Well, maybe I'll get some angry orcs coming back and ambushing me. Cannot summon a drake inside the throne room, so I usually switch to grab call. And we'll wait for the timer to tick down and then come back. Timer on the Graug is up. One thing really quickly before we go and kill the boss though. So better to have done this before we actually started the mission, but I looked at his vulnerabilities and he has a fear of poison and curse. So for me, it depends on what captain you get, but it'll be better if I can deploy somebody who can either do poison or curse. Also, he is arrowproof, so preferably someone with melee attacks and who doesn't focus on ranged attacks. So this guy is going to be pretty tough, actually, because he is immune to execution, he's immune to frost, and he's immune to arrows. So I thought I would deploy a captain that will be a little bit more effective against him and can hopefully keep him stunlocked. So I swapped over to Golem the Screamer, and we'll see how Golem does. He is vulnerable to beasts, but if there's any beast in the room, if the captain has a mount, for example, a Caragor mount, I'll just take out the mount really quick at the beginning, and then he should be able to help quite a bit against the boss. So let's see how we go.
Fortress.
So for captains, what I like to do is set things up so that most of the enemy, most of the forces are on my side. If it's a challenging captain, you know, I could just jump down and fight it, but instead I'm going to show you the easy way to do it. So what I'll do is I'll swap over so that I can dominate the enemies and pull them up one by one until I've dominated everything, then go down and face the captain. So that's the easiest way to do it. You don't have to do it this way, but I'll just show you so those of you who struggle can use this strategy.
Yeah.
We can just let our captain kill him, hopefully. Although he's doing silly things. There we go, I was waiting for that to happen. I tend to like making marauders the overlord because that'll change the region so that you find more Mirian around, and there are Mirian chests that are just sort of populated in the zone. So I'll usually do that, but I try to find one that I'll want to keep in the position for a while. I'm going to be replacing all of these orcs later on once I hit level 60 anyway, so I'll just pick a marauder. Normally with sieges, or defenses of fortresses, I like to have all of my orcs leveled up to max, and all of my defenses deployed and everything like that, but this is a scripted event, so you really just need to focus your attention on the Nazgul, and make sure you're paying attention to the prompts. It's good to have your captain bodyguard out if you need it.
His fall was most tragic. His rage knows no bounds.
The Dark Lord will have his prize. Creature of Gondor. That fortress is a tiny island surrounded by a sea of darkness. And the tide rises against you.
reckon you've got him handled. I'll worry more about his pets.
You hold this fort for the Bright Lord. You will not falter!
So just topping up health and health shot.
You are brave, wounds will slow him. What about yours?
Fire and Fury is one of the harder quests and harder boss fights in the game, because you not only have to deal with Helm, you also have to deal with two of his drakes at the same time. So if you can, try and get them on the ground and put something between you and them. It doesn't always work, so you know, just keep moving around, putting walls between you and the drakes, and focus on the Nazgul.
I'm making a habit of saving you.
I think I prefer the version where you don't impale me.
Where is the Nazgul?
Nearby. Can you keep up?
Do my best. That was not the first time for you to face Helm, was it?
I've faced each Ringwraith more times than I can count.
And you've never defeated them?
Not yet.
Then why do you keep fighting?
In the war against darkness, sometimes stalemate is victory.
For now, the battle must be won.
Servants, the drakes are most dangerous.
If we could dominate one, we could turn the weapon of the enemy against him.
Like a ring of power. You do nothing to dispel my fears, Elf Lord.
That's an execute on a down break, by the way.
To Barad-dûr, growing in strength until it can again take physical form.
So, they are banished from death.
Me either. Morning after I work.
Thank you.
knows that you serve him. But your she-elf friend, I will take her head and hands as trophies. You will bleed every trot weakening.
My dreams drive me. should have given me your daughter's hand when I asked.
For your daughter's safe return.
Please, don't fight him.
If you kill me, you'll start a war.
War has come!
You stood beside Sauron as he gave these kings the very rings that doomed them!
Those rings were meant to bring order. Sauron deceived me. He deceived us all.
Knowing what you know now, still, you crafted a new ring.
He crafted a ring. Why else did you pick up my hammer? It is not noble men we are dominating, but savage orcs. And it is with this army that all Sauron has wrought will be undone.
No matter the cost.
A drake would have been a great asset.
With the Gravewalker's quest, you're going to be fighting a lot of whites, which are not too difficult, and a very special guest, and I won't spoil it until we get there.
Whenever I find you, I know the Nazgul must be close.
As long as you wear that ring, they will be closer than you like.
For now, I have no choice. How many Nazgul are there?
Just one.
Isildur.
The king who cut the one ring from Sauron's hand.
And wore it on his own. This is the legacy of your rings, Celebrimbor.
These men died at Minas Ithil.
These are no longer men! Do not hesitate! The only mercy for them is death!
You're
denying them rest, turning them against their brothers. Is there no foul stratagem the Witch King will not employ?
They were your comrades. Now they are my slaves. Ages past, I commanded armies of men, and now they will again follow me.
Return to your rest.
Tremble as your friends turn against you.
Isildur must be nearby.
You will submit to the Witch King, and at our side you will serve. You as my puppet. You have a choice before you.
You don't.
Cannot prevail. You still do not understand, but you will be made to. All who are called will serve the Dark Lord. There is no escape, even in death.
Castamir.
He serves the Dark Lord still.
Thank you.
Isildur will raise more of Gondor's fallen. I will track him. You and I will meet again.
Well, as long as I wear this ring, I'm sure that is true.
He swells his ranks as fast as we deplete them. There is no stronger enemy.
All enemies have a weakness.
Or a strength that can be used to our advantage.
Without spoiling anything, this is as far as we can take the Eltariel questline right now. We will have to do the Bruce questline next and capture some forts and do some other things, and then we will get another quest, which we'll get to in a later episode. So I'll end this episode here. Thank you all for watching, and see you in the next one.